Dear mayors, dear friends and colleagues, a warm welcome to the Embassy of Denmark in Kyiv. And I'm sorry I cannot address you directly, but due to a temporary staff shortage at the embassy, we had to do this as a recorded message. But my greetings are just as heartfelt as if I'd been with you in person. First of all, I wish to thank you, Lead with Europe and the European Anti-Corruption Initiative, EUACI, for the invitation to speak this morning at the opening of your online forum. It is an excellent and very timely initiative that illustrates that both ULEAD and EUACI are continuing their work despite the protracted COVID-19 crisis. I wish to commend the staff and management of the two programs for adapting so diligently to the pandemic and simply carry on your important work. I also wish to extend warm greetings to the mayors and the municipal staff taking part this morning. Local authorities, both in Denmark and in Ukraine, have been in the forefront of the battle against the virus, mobilizing vast resources. Please convey my warm thanks to all those in your municipalities, whether in Denmark or in Ukraine, who are part of this epic struggle, which is far from over yet. Now, the theme of your forum is how to build a business-friendly municipality. This is a highly relevant question. I'm pleased that you will have Danish inspiration for your discussions. Danish municipalities are partners in many ways, but they're also fierce competitors when it comes to attracting new businesses and new inhabitants. Every year there is a national ranking of Danish municipalities in terms of their attractiveness as a business location. It is based on a number of parameters, for instance, how long does it take to get a construction permit, what are the local labor market conditions, and what is the level of local taxes on businesses. When investors look at where to locate new investment, they actually look at the ranking, and their final choice is very often influenced by the ranking. And this internal competition is a win-win for both the municipalities and for the business community. The municipality of Guldborgsund is doing very well in the Danish ranking of the ease of doing business, and it has an ambition to be among the most business-friendly municipalities in Denmark. And they've been very attractive and very successful in attracting new businesses, so it's very appropriate that you have the mayor of Guldborgsund and his team to take part in today's forum. Now, you might think that Denmark is very different from Ukraine and that it would be hard to use the Danish experience here. But there are big differences, of course, but there's one thing that is common in this area. In Ukraine, there's also competition among municipalities and local communities and regions in attracting new businesses and investments. I can tell you because very often Danish companies considering investments in Ukraine will ask the embassy for advice in terms of where to locate, for instance, a new factory. And the number of such requests is actually increasing because some Danish companies are considering moving their manufacturing facilities in the Far East closer to their markets in Europe. And in this context, Ukraine is a very attractive location. So what is the advice that we give the companies when they ask us? Well, first of all, that they should be aware that corruption is still an issue in Ukraine, though major progress has been achieved in the fight against corruption. We also tell them that they should look at the integrity cities as a possible location because they are the vanguards and the pioneers when it comes to integrity, compliance, and the fight against corruption. So my basic message to you this morning is the following. To be an integrity city is good for your citizens, it's good for your local community, and it's good for Ukraine, but it's also good for attracting new businesses and investments. So continue the good work. Denmark is proud, as part of Team Europe, to be your allies and your supporters in the fight against corruption. I wish you a very productive forum. Thank you for your attention.